This episode is brought to you by Skillshare. The first 1,000 people to sign up using the link in the description will get their first 2 months free.
Can you really prove if someone is lying by hooking them up to a machine and running some tests? Apparently so, if you use a polygraph, otherwise known as a lie detector. It works by measuring changes in the body such as blood pressure, pulse, respiration, and skin conductivity when a person is asked a series of questions. How reliable is a lie detector, and are the results ever wrong? That's what we intend to get to the bottom of. In this episode of the Infographics Show, how can you beat a lie detector? Before we answer this question, let's first look back at the history of the polygraph machine. Understanding when someone is lying was considered important way back in ancient China, and one of the first established methods was to look for signs of stress, because when a person lies, they become stressed. One sign of this stress is when a person's mouth starts to go dry. So to test this, the Chinese would ask the person being questioned to chew a handful of rice during the interrogation. Once the interview was over, the grains would be spat out and examined. If the rice was moist, they knew the person was likely being truthful, and if the rice was dry, that meant the person was lying. Jumping forward to the 1900s, we have Sir James Mackenzie, a Scottish cardiologist and a pioneer of medical work, studying the heart and its function in the body. In his 1902 book, The Study of the Pulse, he described an instrument he had invented called a polygraph, which allowed the user to correlate a person's pulse with the beat of the heart itself. When a person was hooked up to the machine, it would scratch out the pattern of the heart rate onto paper via an ink writing device. This allowed irregularities in the heart rate to be detected visually, but it was a rudimentary contraption, and it wasn't until 1921 in Berkeley, California, when the official polygraph machine for lie detecting was invented. The machine was presented by a medical student named John Augustus Larson. He had decided to build a device to assist investigators in criminal cases. This also led him to being the first person ever to measure more than one body process at a time. Okay, so to understand how to beat the detector, we need to know exactly how it functions. When a person takes a polygraph test, they have sensors attached to their body to pick up different signals. Some things that are measured include breathing rate, the person's pulse, their blood pressure, and their perspiration, and sometimes a polygraph will also record arm and leg movements. The questioner starts by asking 3 or 4 simple questions to establish what is considered normal bodily responses when the person responds. These are the control questions. Then the real questions being tested by the polygraph are asked and compared. Throughout questioning, all of the person's signals are recorded on the moving paper. A polygraph examiner can observe the graphs as the test is happening to see how the person is reacting and judge whether or not they are being truthful. Changes such as heart rate speeding up, blood pressure increasing, and a person starting to sweat more indicates that they are lying. But is a polygraph test really accurate? The accuracy of polygraph testing is controversial and can never be 100%. The American Psychological Association stated in a 2004 report, there is no evidence that any pattern of psychological reactions is unique to deception. For example, an honest person might be nervous when answering truthfully, and a dishonest person may be confident enough to keep their cool. The APA also reported that there is evidence to suggest that typical polygraph examinations detect deception better than chance, but with error rates that can result in failing to detect guilty people. Okay, so that means the test can be beaten, right? From our research, it seems there are a few ways to try and beat the test, but it's not as simple as imagining happy thoughts while lying and stressful ones while telling the truth. So what is the best way to outsmart the lie detector test? According to Dr. Ann Helmenstein, a PhD in biomedical sciences, the two best ways to beat the test are 1, to get completely into a Zen state of mind, or remain totally stressed out during the test. Easy, right? If you're a Buddhist monk, maybe so, but few of us have this much control over our mood. One way to trick the test is to identify the questions that are irrelevant, the control questions. Examples of irrelevant control questions that have nothing to do with the interrogation are, what is your name? Or what city do you live in? When asked these questions, change your heart rate, respiratory rate, blood pressure, and the amount you sweat. Then, when you answer the relevant questions, even if you lie, it will look like a normal response as compared to the control answers you gave. But how can you make your body behave this erratically? Some of the suggestions we found online include thinking scary thoughts when you recognize a control question, or make yourself sweat by trying to work out a tricky math problem in your head, like dividing 243 by 7, or even bite your tongue to cause yourself pain, as pain produces a similar physiological response as lying. We also found an article in British newspaper The Mirror who interviewed Doug Williams, a police officer who joined the force in Oklahoma in 1972, and as part of his training, actually went to polygraph school. As time passed, he began to tire of the process of doing test after test, and so began to wonder exactly how effective the results were. Williams eventually worked out his own unique way to cheat the system. He explained to radio show This American Life, "It wasn't until my friend came in and started talking about the pucker factor and tightening up the anal sphincter muscle when he was under stress. And that, as it turned out, proved to be the trick to duping the polygraph machine, clenching your anus." Why did this work, I hear you ask? It's because tightening up the anal sphincter muscle and stopping bowel movements creates a cardio rise. Planning on beating a lie detector test anytime soon, or maybe interested in a job with your local police department? Why not try a class on criminal law on Skillshare? With classes from forensic psychology to online security, Skillshare has the tools you need to develop your career or help you launch a brand new one. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 20,000 classes in criminal law, programming, drawing, and more. Premium membership will give you unlimited access to topics that will improve your skills and your life. Join the millions of other people who are using Skillshare and get 2 months absolutely free. To sign up, go to skillshare.com/infographics34 or click the link in the description and start learning today. So, though a lie detector can reveal whether a person is telling the truth or not, it looks like it's also possible to beat it. Do you know of other techniques that can be used to fool a lie detector? If so, let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called What Are the Signs That You Are a Psychopath? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.